Yeah, still on the Star Wars, Putri, as the film actor, there might be a few signs that you have made it big time. Your name in the light of perhaps your first award.
Yes, but when you have the director of the biggest film of the year asking you to play a part in his movie, that is as good a sign as any.
That's true, and such is the case for three Indonesian actors who millions of people will see in Star Wars The Force Awakens. Here it is.
The badassery displayed by Iko Uwais, Yayan Ruhian, and Cecep Arif Rahman in the Raid saga was responsible for countless jaws that have dropped across the globe. And one in particular belongs to J.J. Abrams, as he could not wait to include the three actors in his newest blockbuster flick, Star Wars The Force Awakens, bringing some intense martial arts skill to a galaxy far, far away. Granted, Iko, Yayan, and Cecep played minor roles in the adventure of Finn and Rey, but even global household name like Daniel Craig had to be content to play a stormtrooper, while Brit funnyman Simon Pegg had to make do with being a masked foot trader. Yes, the involvement of Indonesian actors in this highly anticipated Star Wars installment brought a breath of fresh air to Indonesia's film scene, resulting in not just happy fans, but also proud fellow countrymen.
Actually, when the first time we saw Kang Yayan, Iko, and Kang Cecep on the big screen, we screamed.
The unexpected move in casting was not only surprising to fans, but also to the action stars themselves.
Ya ini terus terang kalau tawaran ini dari awalnya sih kita nggak tahu sama sekali, dan Gareth dia merahasiakan itu kurang lebih 6 bulan sebelum dia. Bilang ke saya.
Orang lain untuk bisa terlibat di film tersebut sampai harus melewati 7 tahapan casting. Kita malah hanya diajak ngobrol dan langsung diajak kan, langsung, ayo kita ingin kalian muncul di film saya.
Star Wars The Force Awakens was the biggest film in 2011, breaking many records including sinking Titanic to number 3 in US all-time box office list. Its release was also a long time coming as the last anthology film hit theaters back in 2005. So it was nothing out of the ordinary when the filmmakers withheld much information from the media, though the shroud of secrecy surrounding the project was particularly thick. When we were working on
this story, we wanted... Nggak boleh. Ada pas kita pertama datang, kita diajak sama produsernya ke set. Ada salah satu set yang pas perang banyak itu. Kita mau masuk, di stop. Kata produsernya, enggak, ini sama kita. Enggak, lihat handphonenya. Handphonenya kita di barcode. Jadi, handphone kamera depan sama belakang itu di barcode.
Hampir 2 tahun. Dan kami baru bisa bilang, iya, kami terlibat di Star Wars itu, kalau nggak salah 3 hari menjelang premiere.
Although mum's the word for almost 2 years, brushing elbows with the iconic Han Solo, aka Harrison Ford, and new addition John Boyega and Daisy Ridley was an amazing payoff.
Wow, rambut saya yang keriting langsung meong. Itu merinding. Jadi begitu kan kita dikasih ada dua lembar gitu kan. Dua lembar skrip dibilangin coba kamu lihat lawan bicara kamu. Begitu dilihat ada bla 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 Han Solo. Wow, gitu kan. Serius
yang pemeran yang John Boyega juga, terus dengan yang pemeran Rey juga. Kita sering ngobrol sebelum naik ke apa diambil untuk syutingnya. Kita kadang sering ngobrol dulu. Harus
bagi-bagi. So what's next for the three powerhouses?
Kalau sekarang saya lagi kerjain film lokal, film Indonesia, action juga, headshot sama Mo Brothers, dan sudah selesai, hampir selesai, kurang lebih 90% lah.
With fellow The Raid alum Joe Taslim joining the cast of the newest Star Trek.